Hey, it's Justin here, and I'm really excited today because my family and I are planning a trip to Belize, and we're working on our vacation budgets. We've been saving up for this for quite a while. We all have our airline money set aside, along with money for food, souvenirs, and excursions. The last piece of the puzzle is deciding how many nights we want to stay at each of the two hotels we've chosen. And to make this decision, I'll need some help from you. My family and I decided to split our time between two different parts of the country, which means we'll need to stay at two different hotels. This hotel on the left costs $300 per night, and the hotel on the right costs $425 per night. We don't know how many nights we would like to stay at each hotel. Those are our two variables that we don't have the answer to yet. But we do know we would like to spend up to 10 nights total between the two hotels. We also have a budget of a maximum of $4,000 to spend on our hotel stays. So how do we figure out the best option? Well, by the end of this unit, you'll have all the skills you need to help us decide how many nights to stay at each hotel. To make this decision, we'll need to use a system of linear equations, which is what our next algebra unit is all about. By the end of this unit, you'll be able to help me and my family make the best choice for us. We're going to start off this unit by learning how to solve systems of linear equations. There are three main strategies that we'll learn how to use. These are graphing, substitution, and elimination. Once we have that background knowledge, we'll be able to use this to solve real-life scenarios and extend our skills further to when our systems have inequalities rather than equal signs. I've said the phrase system of linear equations a lot, and before I show you what I mean by this, what do you think a system of equations could be? Think about what the word system means and what an equation means. Let's take a look and see how you did with your prediction.
A system of equations is when we have two or more equations that share the same variables. More specifically, in this unit, we'll be working with systems involving two linear equations. This just means we're working with the same kinds of equations you've been using in the last few units, ones that make straight lines when graphed, and we're only working with two equations at a time. The goal with a system of equations is to be able to solve it, which means finding the solution or solutions that makes both equations in the system true. So you may be thinking, well, what is a solution to a system of equations? Here's an example of a system where both linear equations use the variables x and y. A point is a solution to a system when it's a solution to both individual equations, and therefore makes both equations true. For example, here, an x value of 6 and a y value of 1 makes the first equation true, and also the second equation. So that's a solution to the system. Take this problem, for example. It says, is the point 5, 1 a solution to the system shown below, and why? Well, what needs to be true for this point to be a solution to the system? Yeah, when we substitute the x and y values of the point into each equation, we need to get true statements. Give this problem a try. Pause the video here. For this first equation, if we substitute 5 for x and 1 for y and simplify, do we get a true statement? Yes, we do. 1 does equal 1. Now, we need to check if we get a true statement for the second equation too. If you got stuck somewhere and need a moment to work through this second equation, pause the video now. Okay, let's see. Substituting in 5 for x and 1 for y gives me 7 equals 9? Well, that's not true. I guess this point is not a solution to this second equation. So if a point is a solution to one equation in the system, but not the other, is it a solution to the entire system? No, for a point to be a solution to the system, it has to be a solution to both equations in the system. So our answer to this original question is no. 5, 1 is not a solution to the system because it does not make both equations true. So that's what it means to be a solution to a system. As you can see in this video, we'll be continuing to work with linear equations throughout this entire unit. So be sure to keep those notes from the previous units handy and keep the skills you've learned strong. I'm excited to see where all this takes us and what you decide is the best option for my family's vacation plans. To stay in a bungalow, lie on the beach, see different wildlife. Oh, it's going to be great. Hey, hey.